No one else knew this but me, but it became my very first conviction. My gender was my very first "this I know for sure" moment, as Oprah likes to call it.
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, can you hear me?
Mic check
is a show where we conduct various street interviews geared to hear the voice of the hardworking class residents of New York City. Every second of every minute of the day, week, month, and year, there is always something happening in this city. The problem is, the majority of our stories are being told for those media conglomerates that only spit out one-sided views. Mic check's mission is to give a full 360 degree on major events, protests, and political agendas that matter to you the most. We are here to inform, educate, and entertain the working class residents with information that is vital to your survival.
Gender Expression Non-Discrimination Act, or GENDA, is an act that is trying to be passed into law that will further extend the rights of citizens in this country, primarily New York City, to equal treatment for those who identify and express themselves according to their gender, regardless of what they are biologically assigned to. However, many state legislators have constantly put a hold or ban on the bill due to various employment, societal, and even biological reasons. Although many LGBT and transgender nonconformant argue that they may possess anatomic parts of their once assigned sex, they have not, do not, or will not carry any characteristics of the same sex. For example, expressing masculinity or femininity in any shape, way, or form via clothing, mannerisms, or any other form of gender norms. However, there has been several victories in this fight regarding the Marriage Equality Act, an act that would allow same-sex couples the right to marry in New York State. The Healthcare Equality Act, or HEI, an act that provides exclusive healthcare services to those of the LGBT. The Dignity for All Students Act, or DASA, is an act that ceases and prohibits all students from any form of hazing and bullying to many youth, regardless of sex, sexual orientation, gender identity, or expression. And the Every Child Deserves a Family Act, or the ECDFA, is a law that prohibits discrimination to any couple via same-sex from adopting a child regardless of their identity. In summary, the fight for LGBT rights in this society rages on for total acceptance for all forms of gender, gender expression, identity, and orientation.
If you think life is complicated, try dealing with a transgender girl texting a boy she just met at school.
I came out as being a trans man, a female to male transsexual, and it was July of 2006.
I was probably about 4 years old when I knew that I was a girl. No one else knew this but me, but it became my very first conviction. My gender was my very first "this I know for sure" moment, as Oprah likes to call it.
My preferred gender pronoun is gay because I consider myself a happy individual. That's the meaning of the word.
Stud. Aggressive girl. Like, I'm aggressive female. I'm not a femme. I do think more managed than regular females, basically.
I'm a female, but I announce myself as bi.
I identify myself as a tranny, butch queen, and trade. But I love being a tranny because, like, tranny, you get your way and all that, so.
My PGP, I don't have a PGP. Doesn't matter if it's he, she, or whatever. Just don't be disrespectful. That's just one thing I don't like. But what I do like to be called is unicorn because it's the highest of all gay. And I like to think that I'm at the highest of all gay.
Barbie, now she, or whatever.
I identify myself as male.
I've always felt male, like, my entire life. And I realize that certain people haven't. And if they feel like they're not male, and if they can truly recognize within their hearts that they're not, then that means that they're not. And I feel like, who are we to disagree with that, you know?
Person's sex is something that they were born in, I believe, and do not crucify me. And then gender is what they are.
I mean, me being in, you know, this community, you know, the gay community and stuff like that, they use that word a lot to identify different parts and different people in our community. Like, you have some trannies, you have FTMs, which are female to males, you have MTF, which are male to females. You have, you know, they call them butch queens, which are feminine guys. It's just a whole bunch of ways to break down the categories in different people.
I mean, they're very the same, because you can be, you can say that you're a man, born a female. But I mean, it's kind of actually the same thing in a way. But when it comes to like what each of them are, like sex is what you're born or who you have sex with. That can also mean it. But it means mostly the way you were born, male or female, or both. It's intersex. It's a forgotten problem. Not a problem, but it's a forgotten, you know, letter in the LGBT community.
Because if the great state of New York, a place that led in the women's rights movement, that was a leader in the Underground Railroad, a place where the modern LGBT civil rights movement was born, if our state affirmatively allows discrimination based on what is in our state human rights law, we can't really say we're a free state. We cannot say we're a state that embraces and supports everyone. And I fear that that will just spread.
We'll be right back right after this.
My child cannot be a faggot. My child cannot be a faggot.
Why are you such a failure? Why are you such a failure?
You are not my child. You are not my child.
You're nothing but a mistake. You're nothing but a mistake.
You're worthless. You're worthless.
To mic check.
What part of being transgender hurts you the most?
my genitalia. Because right now I feel like a girl, but when I look down there, it reminds me.
My orientation, I have been treated differently because I've been kicked out of bars and discriminated against on the train, in school. It's happened to me before in my life, yeah.
Yes, I was actually at Temptations as a club, Jamaican club. I threw a birthday party there like 2 years ago for my birthday. I guess he didn't know that I was a female, so when I went, because it was free party for females or whatever, and they charged me instead of letting me do it free because of how I looked.
Yes, I have been treated differently. And I remember one time I was going to school with my ex, and somebody threw a bottle glass at her.
Every day. When I was in ninth grade, I started dyeing my hair. I came into school with blue hair. And everyone looked at me like I was, or an actual unicorn. But usually every day because of my red hair. And I guess the way that I present myself, everyone's just like closed-minded in a way.
People, they probably be shocked or whatever. They might think I'm a girl at first, then they figure it out. But personally, I don't care what nobody think, because who's them? You ain't made me. You don't say what the fuck I should look like or whatever. So personally, I don't care what nobody think. I'll be me regardless, so I don't care.
Actually, I've had an experience with that too, because I was in drag. I walked into a pizza shop and I ordered an entire pie and I was thrown out. I still think about that sometimes, but then it's like, I really don't care because, I mean, I'm a so I had the store shut down, so I really don't care anymore.
It's very much fear. I read this quote from Joe Rogan. He said, there's only two reasons why a person would reject another person who is gay. Either A, fear of burning in hell or something like that. And the second one was the sex would be great if they tried it with the same sex. So it's very much fear. And it's not just fear of religion, but maybe fear of themselves. A lot of people I know who are homophobic have like an inner desire to, in lack of a better word, let their flower grow. You know, it's ignorance, you know, and it's not being open to learning new things. I think it's either ignorance or fear.
High school, any type of high school, public or private, and in poverty-stricken areas.
Why do you think?
Because it's a lower income level for people, so when you're, after a while, if you're surrounded by that same territory for wild periods of time, you start to think that's what the jail is set up for, and that's what, it's a project made from the government.
Home, work, and your community. For home, it would be parents who are who are religion-based or culture-based, and it's not in their culture to think that way, or if they feel that if you were born something, you stay that way, when it's not true. And then there's work and school. If someone was transgendered in high school, it was very, it was considered to be, I don't know how to explain it. It was, in a way, disrespectful to, the women or the men or whatever, because they felt like they were imitating them. And in reality, it's just who they are. And what else? In work, if someone's trans, a lot of like coworkers just look at you differently and act differently, I guess. And in the communities, for me, I personally see it in the LGBT community. And it's contradiction, because we're trying to fight for our rights, yet we downgrade anyone who isn't like us.
Especially with the people that live in this neighborhood. I mean, we all come from different places to come down here and chill and hang out and stuff like that. People come down here, you know, sometimes we do get a little out of hand. We might be drunk or something down here. But you get the police that, you know that we're just coming down here to chill on the pier, have a good time, try to run us out the streets, ask us, you know, we get locked up for being down here if we don't have an ID that says, you know, we are from this neighborhood or have an address in this neighborhood. Another thing is you have some people that are homophobic and straight. And some way, somehow, they end up on West 4th and they come out and act like they don't know where they're at. Like, oh, f*** you, you know, cursing, gay bashing, you know, calling people faggots and out of their names and stuff like that.
And people that are more harder, more manly, find out, you know, that's easy prey, I guess. So it's like, it trickles down to like teasing, like the bullying thing, like, I have more than you, so I can, type of thing.
I have 250 young, homeless, transgender men and women in my care. And as somebody who's responsible for caring for transgender youth, it's heartbreaking and devastating to see what they go through. Our kids are desperate to find jobs, but transgender kids have the hardest time finding jobs of any homeless kids. And many, many of our young people feel condemned to turn to prostitution just to support themselves. And when our transgender youth turn to prostitution, overwhelmingly they become infected with HIV. And when our transgender youth become infected with HIV, very many of them become so despondent that they attempt to kill themselves. Everybody wants their kids to have a fair shake. Everybody wants their kids to be safe. So please, pass GENDA now.
We'll be right back. Right after this.
Every time.
And every time.
You hear. About young people being murdered.
About young people being murdered.
Either by police. Or by racist vigilantes. You have people. Who say. Okay. Maybe what happened there is wrong. But you know. These youth are no good. They can't be about nothing. Well, I'm here to say. You're wrong. Yes, they can.
And now, back to Mic Check.
You had laws of the 14th Amendment in the 1860s to protect African American people, but it wasn't fleshed out for 100 years yet. It took women 75 years to get the right to vote after they started meeting. Gays and lesbians, it's taken 30 years. Transgender people who have moved from the gender of their birth to a new gender identity, it takes time, it takes work, it takes lobbying, it takes visibility, like Vandy Beth Glenn.
I think it shouldn't be passed at all, because it's only going to cause unnecessary trauma after previous events of past experiences like World Trade Center. Because it would cost money, number one. It would cost the government expenses that we don't unnecessarily need. We have a $14 trillion deficit as far as government goes. But financing would be one, and then again, unnecessary stress is another.
You know, I had a friend or whatever. No, she was like me, a stud, AG. She went out town with this guy, and he chopped her up just because he does not like gay people. So if discrimination was passed as illegal, that will actually protect some people. More people will get jobs. Like, it wouldn't be different. It would be regular.
I mean, I'm all for it because it doesn't make sense for anyone to be discriminated against because of how they portray themselves or how they feel about themselves. Because, to be perfectly honest, it's none of anyone else's business, yeah. For one.
It needs to be passed. Like, I feel like we are now unleashing problems that have, that's been there, and it's been in the world, and yet no one wants to really like to realize it. And in New York City, like, we really need to pass it because it makes no sense. Same-sex marriage is legalized. We can adopt. What's stopping us from passing this? Is it religion? If that's the case, then really we have to like review that, because I believe what they said, and if I'm not right, or social studies back in what, fifth grade, you do not mix religion and the government together. They're solely two different branches, and you're not supposed to mix them. So what's stopping you? And this is very important, because there are a lot of people who are non-gender conforming, and it's very important. Because that little percent what, 32, no, 78, so that's what, 22? The little 22% are those who are filled with nothing but hate. And I feel like it's Congress's way of satisfying their hate. We can get marriage equality, we can have kids, and we can do, you know, we can do all this little stuff, but I feel like they want something to satisfy the hate in, like, New York State.
What can you do about that, you know? It's politics. That's what they do as business people, people that are already employed.
It's not, like, the end of the world. And I'm gonna succeed without you in my life, or without your hate, like, drowning my inner thoughts, you know.
I get a lot of people that say, you know, you're trying to be a guy, you dress like one, you look like one. My thing is, I can actually get a sex change if I wanted to be one. You know what I'm saying? I'm just me, I'm Lex, this is the way I'm comfortable, this is how I live my life. It's not even a sex thing with me, I just love women, you know, I adore women, that's it.
I feel like everybody should be they self and have fun with what you do. You only get one life, and live it to the fullest. Don't let nobody hate you, just do what you have to do. You here to do what God made you to do. What everybody else say, and do what you have to. None of these out here is real, everybody's fake. Some of them is fake, some is real, so.
Be the master of your own life. Don't let anyone else take your steering wheel while you're pressing the pedal. Don't let anyone press your brakes until you die.
So what can we do to help further pass gender equality in this city? Take action, join a campaign. Let your council members know the time for ending discrimination on gender identity needs to come to an end. Email the mayor and let him or her know the importance of passing the GENDA Act in New York City and what positive effects it will have in further extending the rights for civil citizens in this city. Remember, this is a community effort. No one stands alone on this. Thank you.
down by the police. They're being trapped and sent to prisons for lifetimes. Over 80,000 people are in solitary confinement, treated worse than animals. This is a criminal system. It was founded on slavery. You had 100 years of Jim Crow terror, and now you have the new Jim Crow, and it's not going to end until we end this system. This is why we're talking about real revolution. We're out here to fight for justice for Trayvon Martin. But we're also here because 30 years from now, 20 years from now, we don't want to be looking at this again.
Hey, Abby.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. So I got you some coffee. Just for you. So I have to talk to you about something. I've been meaning, I guess, to like say this for a while, and I know. So basically, I'm gay. Like, I like girls.
You're gay. Lesbian. You're lesbian.
Yeah.
Like girls. Is there any other game you can play that's not this? You know I don't like anything that has to do with gay.
Look, it's who I am. It's not like I haven't, I guess, tried to avoid it, but it's not something I can avoid anymore.
I can't deal with this. I'm sorry. I can't deal with this.